Enter your name, pilot.
Okay, welcome to another Play Something Old School, TIE Fighter. Tonight we're going to start on the missile boat obstacle course and training missions. Answering the question. What does it take to beat a TIE Fighter? To beat a TIE Defender? A missile boat. So, without too much more preamble, let's get rolling.
Problem.
Okay, I need to make an adjustment here. Yep, having a slight technical glitch. Okay. It's not happy. Generally, that really bad laggy response time there is a sign that game was not shut down properly previously, and thus it's trying to run two instances of the same process at once.
Enter your name, pilot.
Which is not optimal. There we go. All right. So, best record was TIE Advanced, level 14. Gunboat made it to level 12, and the Defender made it to level 12. Really have no idea how far I'm going to get with the missile boat. Probably not level 14. The missile boat is a bit slower than the TIE Defender. It only has one gun. So you burn through your energy reserve a lot faster. A couple of big tricks that we'll see and I'll show off in training in a bit. The slam boosters and the insane amount of warheads that it carries. Neither of them especially useful in the training simulator obstacle course. Show off the slams real quick here. That button is anyway. So the boosters double your speed, but they do it by eating your laser energy. Capacitor. So the obstacle course where pick up more time by destroying targets, that speed boost just isn't worth it. The other hand, as I showed in the TIE Defender, raw speed isn't necessarily the be-all, end-all, and you end up bouncing off a wall too fast. So, we'll see. This thing is pretty fast. It's in the vicinity of, I forget how fast the TIE Advanced actually goes, but it's in that neighborhood. little slower than a bright. But the biggest thing is, it's tough. It's tough to run this in a scenario where you're reliant on your gun, because you only have one. Everything outside of this, you have crazy amounts of warheads to fire. Pretty much always a tractor beam or jamming beam. Ship basically, see this in the training missions. Strategy for flying this is basically find your target, you lock your target up with your tractor beam, you shoot it with missiles, it dies, you go on to the next thing. That's what this thing does. If you're having to use your gun something for anything other than boosting your shields or running your booster, something's gone wrong. That's it for shield energy. Some speed here. One good thing in the maze with this ship is at least the gun is center mounted, so you don't miss a lot of shots. It's chin mounted, so you miss a couple, but not bad. Certainly better than the TIE bomber. Advanced. Or the TIE interceptor. Is going to have a little bit of an increased charge going in. Really hampered a bit in here by not having access to all the things that make it unique. Five targets in a pass, pretty good though. Two. Five. Should have been six. Keep it going a little bit longer. that up in later levels here. The opening and that revolving bulkhead there. Was close. Good. That's gonna happen sooner or later. Should be recoverable at this stage, though. A little sketchy here. Start doing here. Hit the slams. Between segments. It's kind of where we want that speed. Slow up a little bit. Coming through. Not sure if this is helpful or not. Juice. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe with a full capacitor, but that's taking two hits on the red things. Getting through everything as it is. Well, you get to level 12 anyway. So it's on par with the Defender for how far I managed to get. Something anyway. So I actually made it farther than in the Defender. Of course, I crashed into a bunch of stuff in the Defender, so... it's kind of a your mileage may vary scenario. Pretty sure this is where it's gonna end, though. Slams in here. Kind of a last ditch effort. Believe that worked. There's no way it's going to get through this one. Okay. So this equaled my TIE advanced. Yep. That's it. We're done. Equaled my TIE advanced record, though. Too shabby. See, there's our training patch. That's it for training.
This mission will teach you basic assault tactics using the dual warhead armament of the new missile boat. Your target will be a Rebel Deep Space manufacturing facility and all the nearby cargo containers. You will use advanced concussion missiles to take out the facility's anti-warhead defense system. Then make a standoff attack using rockets to destroy the installation from a safe distance. Then you are to destroy any cargo containers or other craft using missiles or rockets as appropriate. If you wish, you may remain in the area to engage a supply convoy and then a relief force. The cruiser Arjun will arrive to deliver a combat utility vehicle for you to reload your warheads. Remain on constant alert for Factory Station 1 to launch any starfighters or for the arrival of reinforcements. This mission, your objective is to practice assault tactics on a fixed installation using the dual warhead capability of Cygnus's new missile boat. You will learn how to choose the appropriate warhead for each target. Specifically, you will learn how to overwhelm the target's defensive anti-warhead system with a saturation attack. Once this is done, you can destroy the facility using your heavy weapons without fear of having your warheads intercepted. In addition, you will learn how to use the sublight acceleration motors. The SLAM is an overdrive that boosts engine output to 200%, providing a sudden massive boost of acceleration. The cost is a rapid drain on stored cannon energy. This technology is a new development that is intended to enable the missile boat to counter the TIE Defender. You will fly missile boat Mu-1. This craft is a development of the successful Star Wing assault gunboat from Cygnus. It is faster and more maneuverable than the gunboat. For more information, see the data regarding the SLAMs. Like all new Imperial starfighters, it is equipped with a hyperdrive and deflector shields. The deep space manufacturing facility. You will fly missile boat Mu-1. This craft is a development of the successful Star Wing assault gunboat from Cygnus. It is faster and more maneuverable than the gunboat. For more information, see the data regarding the SLAMs. Like all new Imperial starfighters, it is equipped with a hyperdrive and deflector shields. Armament consists of two large-capacity twin warhead launchers and a single nose-mounted laser. One pair of launchers is dedicated for missiles and holds a total of 40. The other pair is general purpose to allow mission-specific warhead loads. There is also provision for special beam weapons. For this mission, your craft is armed with 20 heavy rockets in addition to the standard missile load. Also, you will have the new, improved tractor beam. The only weakness is the energy recharge rate. Due to the single cannon, it takes just over 90 seconds to reach maximum energy levels from the nominal mission start levels. The deep space manufacturing facility you are going to attack possesses defensive armament consisting of 12 twin turbo lasers and an advanced anti-warhead system. The nearby storage yards and the facility itself may also be protected by a number of Z-95 headhunters. You will drop out of hyperspace less than 13 kilometers from the facility. As you close the distance, charge your shield and laser systems to maximum. Attack range is 6 kilometers. If you wish to continue after the facility is destroyed, a combat utility vehicle will be deployed for you to reload your warheads. You may then proceed to attack a convoy and a relief force.
Okay, move one. Begin charging your laser and shield systems now. Use the map by pressing the M key to plan your attack.
Alright, so primaries, secondaries... Destroy everything.
The shuttles are awaiting shipment, and they're not piloted. Switch to missiles and select dual fire mode.
I want the missiles.
Target the facility's warhead launcher and launch two salvos. Reverse direction and engage the slams. Hit the N key. Note the rapid drain of stored cannon energy.
Just like that. These hit the target here.
The slams shut off automatically when the cannon is drained. Transfer shield energy to the cannon to keep the slams active. When the warhead launcher is destroyed, select rockets. C-95 headhunters have been launched in response to your attack. Destroying the facility will require as many as 14 rockets.
Well, that's simple. Then...
remember to stay outside the facility's gun range, which is 2 kilometers.
Lock them up. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Back off and watch them go in. Tug. Headhunters. It's the factory destroyed. Yep, here come the headhunters.
Now take out the shuttles and containers, but watch your back.
The Z-95 is good for reason, too. Extractor beams and concussion missiles, because they're so good. Good argument for using the tractor beam. Sure. Because it makes them easier to hit.
The missile boat isn't too complicated for you, is it? We can always put you...
ah.
A tug has carried off one of the shuttles you needed to destroy.
Next time around, I'm gonna pop the tugs first. Try this again.
Remember that because you have only one laser cannon, you have a lot less energy to draw on for power transfers to the shields. For this reason, you need to avoid taking hits as much as possible. You shouldn't have any trouble doing this, as you have ample standoff.
Okay, move one. Begin charging your laser and shield systems now. Use the map by pressing the M key to plan your attack.
Alright. So, tugs are gonna come in.
Switch to missiles and select dual fire mode.
Tugs will come in and drag away my shuttles.
Target the facility's warhead launcher and launch two salvos.
That's a higher priority than following those precise orders.
Reverse direction and engage the slams. Hit the N key. Note the rapid drain of stored cannon energy.
We'll pop the shuttle. Pop the tugs with a single concussion missile each.
The slams shut off automatically when the cannon is drained. Transfer shield energy to the cannon to keep the slams active.
Time to time.
C-95 headhunters have been launched in response to your attack.
So the tug. Actually only takes two advanced concussion missiles to pop that warhead launcher.
When the warhead launcher is destroyed, select rockets. Destroying the facility will require as many as 14 rockets.
Start unloading rocket pairs.
Remember to stay outside the facility's gun range, which is 2 kilometers.
6, 8, 10, 12, 14. Switch to guns. Deal with the headhunters. Don't really consider headhunters worth shooting concussion missiles on. Tractor beam to hold them still, sure.
Now take out the shuttles and containers, but watch your back.
Shuttles. Same thing. There's no point in wasting missiles or rockets on. Slams to get there a little faster. Build energy in and slow down. Nothing needs to be inspected. I shoot through the container, I shoot through the container. Argument for using missiles is just run out of cannon energy so fast in this thing. Full recharge, full charge, deplete this thing like crazy. Shields and sure enough, one's enough. So I would have needed to take out a couple of them with guns anyway. Rockets on this guy. Start dealing with the Y-wings here. In this case, go dual concussion missiles. Beams. Lock them up. Shoot him.
Superb shooting. Target destroyed.
Two rockets is enough. Greater than.
Excellent hunting, Mew 1.
And this is basically how you dogfight in this one.
Good work, Mew 1.
You don't dogfight. You lock him in place with a tractor beam, then you shoot two advanced concussion missiles
out. Excellent hunting, Mew 1.
My concussion missiles at the freighters. Go for a reload.
Good hunting, Mew
1. Target destroyed.
Okay.
Good, Judy. Mew 1. Target destroyed.
Last 2% there, shish.
Excellent hunting, Mew 1. Target destroyed.
Time to egress the area. Attention. So now we're going to have to do this the hard way. I got kind of sloppy there. Should have made sure that there weren't spiders hanging around. Which, if you've seen some of my TIE Defender video missions, it's not the first time I've had that particular error.
Good shooting.
Bonus missions. It's the one ship where it's actually sometimes more useful to charge shields instead of charging lasers and dumping those into shields. Thank you. last time, too. That's my wing button.
Shift C. Mute 1. Target. Destroyed.
Shift S.
Request for reinforcements denied.
There are no reinforcements. Well, take out these two container transports with nothing but a laser then. So we'll dump the beam power. Got the shields and lasers. Try to at least accomplish the secondary objectives. Alright, well, the moral of the story is make sure the area is clear before you dock for reloads. And don't go out to third-person view. It's cute. Still a win, though.
You have demonstrated the ability to use the missile boat's dual warhead capability in combat against a variety of targets. In this mission, you will use your missiles to defend a cargo vessel from a multiple warhead attack. Container transport Silver Bull is en route to a rendezvous point near a spec war fabrication facility. The rebels are attacking with 9 armed transports arrayed in a crescent wave attack formation. The lead craft, SAML 1, is moments away from its weapon release point, so you must hurry. A wave of rebel starfighters armed with torpedoes will enter if the first attack is stopped. Shuttle Aluma will deliver a VIP to the Silver Bull while you engage the rebels. Protect that shuttle. The final threat you will face is a combined attack by traitor assault transports and TIE defenders. Though you have a large number of warheads, use them carefully. You'll need them all. One last thing. A pair of TIE fighters from the factory station can be summoned if you need some reinforcements. In this mission, you will use your missiles to defend a cargo. The objective is to defend an Imperial container transport and manufacturing facility using the dual warhead capability of Cygnus's new missile boat. You will learn how to target and intercept enemy warheads using advanced concussion missiles. You will fly missile boat Mu-1. For this mission, your craft is armed with a load of 30 advanced proton torpedoes, in addition to the standard load of 40 advanced concussion missiles. Should you require assistance, you may summon a pair of TIE fighters from the manufacturing facility. There are 9 rebel transports in a staggered crescent wave attack formation. The first 6 are armed with heavy concussion bombs, and the last 3 have heavy rockets. Note that the bombs are hard to see, but won't be moving much faster than the craft which launches them. In any case, you won't have any trouble picking them up on your sensors or in the in-flight map. Hit the W key in the map mode. After the first attack wave is defeated, a series of rebel starfighters will begin to arrive. Beginning with Y-wings and progressing through X-wings and B-wings, they will be making torpedo attacks. Near the end, a pair of A-wings will come in to attempt a missile attack on the VIP shuttle docking with the container transport. Note that your advanced missiles can still catch a rebel missile, providing that your speed is high enough when you launch. Finally, as a bonus, you may try to defeat an attack by traitor assault transports and TIE defenders.
Press the R key, then Z key to observe the nearest enemy launch pods. Use the W key in map mode to show warheads. Shuttle 1 just launched a pair of heavy concussion bombs.
Right, up at the top there.
Switch to missile mode and track until the targeting box is red. Fire your missile and select the next bomb to intercept.
It's a waste of a torpedo.
Whenever you get an opportunity, take out a transport by using two missiles.
Actually, transports. Transports
I'm gonna
use.
Just launched two more bombs. Shuttle 3 just launched two more bombs. Can you handle it?
Transports I'm gonna use proton torpedoes. Space bomb there. space bombs. And an enemy rocket. One guy that I missed.
Good, Hunting Mew 1. Target destroyed.
Great.
Excellent work, Mew
1. All right.
Primary mission objectives completed.
Rebel starfighters are entering the area. Intercept and destroy.
Congratulations, Mew 1. You've done very well. Quite a challenge, wasn't it? You can stop now if you wish.
Reloads, I'm gonna have to be kind of careful with my concussion missiles. These guys I'll use torpedoes on. So I'm gonna have to use their torpedoes. Or not. Alright, didn't save the silver bowl, got the primaries, all look good. Should have called in the TIE fighters for reinforcements. Showed up. Could have been missile shields anyway.
You have demonstrated the ability to use the missile boat's dual warhead capability to defeat a multiple warhead attack. As a pair of Imperial corvettes came out of hyperspace, they found themselves in a minefield. You must save the corvettes by clearing the minefield so a repair transport can rescue them. This is a Type B minefield. A Type B mine is equipped with an ion cannon to disable its targets. As a pair of Imperial corvettes came out of hyperspace, they found themselves in a minefield. Your objective is to help rescue the corvette group Dagger. Your part in this mission includes destroying all the mines around the corvettes, then providing starfighter cover for the corvettes and the repair craft until all three craft can hyperjump to safety. You will have to intercept and eliminate any enemy craft in the area. Remember, the repair craft will not enter the area until all the mines have been destroyed. You will be the flight leader, Missile Boat Tau 1. You will have one wingman. Your craft will be armed with 40 advanced missiles plus 10 space bombs. You will be encountering Type B mines. These type of mines are armed with ion cannons instead of laser cannons. They are used to disable pre-programmed targets, so the disabled craft can be captured or looted. Ion bolts move slower than laser blasts, so they can be avoided easier if you jink. It is likely that those who laid this minefield trap will return to see if they have snared anyone. Pay attention to your in-flight messages because they will alert you to important mission developments.
Dagger 1 to Tau 1, requesting your assistance.
Mission critical craft under attack. Mission critical craft under attack.
Alright. Step 1, clear the minefield.
Be alert, Tau 1.
Be handy for use against the Corvette. On Cal, cruiser. Tractor beam. Is too close for missiles. Switching the guns. Maverick would say.
Boarding operation complete.
That was a waste.
Tau 1, they've launched B-Wings. Hurry.
Using your target for attack.
Yeah, I'll just reload. Still. B-Wings need 3. works really well.
Good shooting. Transmission received. Using your target for attack.
Bulls destroy ship ton of things. Pop the warhead launcher.
Operation begun.
This thing's got two of them. On getting out of range here. My wingman does
not respond. Dagger 1 to Tower 1. Cover us while we make an exit.
Normally, I would lock up an A-wing, hit it with one concussion missile, and then finish with lasers. But lack of weapon. Since I get a lock long enough to actually fire, give him two. There we go. Just need to hold the lock until we do that.
Work.
And they go bye-bye. Him until my heads disappear. Generally, those things will do a good job of finding their targets eventually. But general.
Excellent hunting.
I should lock Omega in a minute because that's my real. Alright. So we got the warhead launcher off this thing. Go ahead and punch off a gun, drop my bombs, and then go for a reload. Just like in the TIE Defender, go max acceleration. Just like in any 2-pack. passes because of how fast I close. Way too fast right now.
Excellent work. Primary mission objectives complete.
Your skills are improving, Talpa. You may stay in the simulation for more training if you wish.
Target destroyed.
Talpa's tower. I'm out of here.
Target destroyed.
Close to him, a lot closer.
Tower one, watch your shields.
All right, should be able to pull this off. Just gonna have to do it smart while I'm killing velocity. Alright. This time I actually did the reload right. Probably.
Operation.
Problem is, it takes a while to load this many concussion missiles. But I put a lot of distance between me and the X-Wings, so good.
Reload operation complete.
Right. Let's engage. Just gonna go in slow. Going head to head. It's a fight I will lose. Good tone. Good rear shot. Take him out. Three more groups of A-Wings and a group of Y-Wings, or X-Wings, rather. miss the part. Wish I had missiles and not bombs. Do what I can with what I got. Still game. There we go. There's no reason to keep my cannons at full charge right now. With mag pulses. There we go. Next wing I can walk on easier. Groups of A-wings left. No problem. These guys have advanced missiles too. That makes a little bit tougher. Left. Three pairs of concussion missiles. If I have to, I'll do this the hard way with guns. I'd really prefer not to. Missiles finished the job there. All right, last enemy, last set of missiles. Fine. Too close for missiles, Goose, switching to guns. I'd even call this a danger zone.
We saved the Imperial Corvette Group Dagger. We also defeated many rebel craft. The missile boat was specifically designed to counter the threat of the TIE Defender. Here, you will be given the opportunity to test yourself against the TIE Defender. Most of the TIE Defenders are parked and should be destroyed before they get operational. The missile boat was specifically... The objective is to completely destroy all of the TIE defenders located at this base. Most are stationary at the outset of the mission, but work quickly before they get manned. The tractor beam has been radically improved. With the high speeds and quick turns that the TIE defender can achieve, the new and improved beam weapon will be very useful. Directing the tractor beam weapon at the TIE defender will defeat its ability to maneuver away from you. You will be the flight leader, Missile Boat Tau 1. You will have one wingman. Your craft will be armed with 40 advanced missiles and 30 advanced torpedoes. You will be attacking a squadron of enemy TIE defenders. They will be your only threat.
Tau 1, TIE Defenders Rover are attacking us. Rover 1 to Tau 1, you and your wingman are toast!
Watch out, Tau 1.
Still... And that's how you deal with TIE Defenders. Shuttles, it's going to be
target destroyed.
One advanced torpedo. Finish with a missile. With a missile.
Target destroyed.
Transport jumped already. Oh well.
Target destroyed.
Keep it for future playthrough.
Excellent shooting.
Because they're not moving.
Good work, good work. Primary mission objectives completed.
You have shown much promise, Tau 1. You may stay in the simulation for more action if you wish. Good work in completing your mission, Tau 1.
Containers. I didn't spec some of the containers for...
Pirate corvettes are joining in the battle.
Target destroyed.
Advanced torpedoes ought to do it there.
Target destroyed. Target destroyed. Target destroyed. Target destroyed. Bird hunting. Target destroyed.
There's a pirate cruiser entering the battle.
Target destroyed. Target destroyed. Transmission received. Using your target for attack. Good hunting. Target destroyed. Superb work. Secondary mission objectives completed. The Emperor will be pleased. Incoming missile.
All the containers have been destroyed.
That's gonna be trouble.
Superb work. Incoming missile. Incoming missile.
Just gonna dual fire on these brights.
Good hunting. Excellent hunting.
You're on your own now, Tower One.
No piss cake. Don't get a lot of boost out of your lasers to shields. Alright, well, we missed a few bonus goals, but we hit all the primaries and the secondaries. Looks good to me.
You proved that the missile boat can go up against a superior number of TIE defenders and be victorious.
All right, well, that is the very last training mission. Thanks for watching. Tune in next time. Next episode, we're going to actually start the first battle. So, as the Imperials clean up after the Battle of Imperial clean up after the Battle of Hoth, rather. So, till next time, thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel, and keep six clear. Good night, everybody.